Welcome. Today we have a special guest. First time, actually. First time on the channel.
Yeah.
Nick Drosis. I've been looking at his channel for a while. I saw that he was having a self-defense, if you want to call it that.
Self-defense
seminar in New York. First one? Second one?
First one, yeah.
First one in New York City. And I signed up immediately, and it was amazing. So self-defense, and what I was saying to Nick today, so I took it yesterday, and what I was saying to Nick today is, coming as a civilian in New York City, 8 million people, and you're having slashings up, you're having pickpocketing up, you literally are having crime up.
Yeah.
And the story that really was like, I got to get on this, was I was on the subway. I was telling Nick,
yeah,
is that I was on the subway, and 7 a.m. in the morning, and this guy is just walking throughout. He looks like he's looking for trouble. He starts cursing. He starts chirping. And I'm thinking, he's going to do something. Maybe, maybe not, because it's the New York City subway. It's not a big deal. And then out of nowhere, he knocks this guy out that's not even looking. He's got his earphones in. He's holding a guitar case. Knocks him out. Sucker punches to the side of the head. The guy goes down, knocked out. The whole train car goes wild. Nobody wants to screw with this guy. He's looking for another suspect.
Nobody jumped in.
He's looking for another suspect, and I'm like, I got to get this handled. And the first thing that I noticed is I had my hands in my pocket.
Yeah.
And, you know, we're going to go over what I thought self-defense was, you know, as a civilian, not someone that has studied it or, you know, yeah, you've been into a fight, but it's totally different when there's a fight because, you know, college, two guys are fighting over a girl, or you're in rugby and, you know, you don't like the other team, you fight, and then it's done 15, 20 seconds max. But when you get it, it's the street, it's New York City, it's a criminal, totally different.
No clue who you're dealing with. You don't know his mindset. You don't know if he's armed, if they're more than one. You know, it's not like, you know, you get into a fight like at a rugby game, like you said.
Yeah.
Cops are going to come in. You'll be able to trace who that person is. That guy who punched that guy out, good luck trying to find him.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It's very different for sure.
Yeah. So I guess maybe start a little bit about your story and, you know, what got you into it and your experience. Because, not to interrupt, but there's people that I either read a book or I meet or whatever, and I want to know their background, because if they're talking about investing, yet they're worth $100,000, I'm like,
yeah,
I'm not going to listen to you. So that was one of the biggest things, is that, you know, your story is very unique.
Yeah, the experience for sure. You know, I grew up in, you know, one of the poorest neighborhoods in Montreal, Park Extension. I started, you know, from a young age, 8 years old, I started doing Kung Fu, and then I did karate, and I did Taekwondo, I did reality-based self-defense. I touched a lot of different systems. I did mixed martial arts. And then what really changed my mindset was when I started working in nightclubs. Then I saw, well, you know, I would be teaching and training certain systems, and then I'd go out in real life and be like, this doesn't actually happen like that. It makes sense when you got a guy who doesn't have training attacking you with a knife in slow motion, and then it's completely different when you have a real fucking street gang trying to attack you full out with a knife.
Oh, yeah.
Or when it's got a gun put to your head, or when there's two guys who are actually ready to jump you.
Yeah.
So I was able to say, well, okay, this makes sense in theory, but in practice, it's going to get you killed. How do I filter everything to make it as simple as possible that even visually watching, you'll be able to learn?
Yeah.
So, you know, that's because a lot of what made me start my YouTube channel is that I saw a lot of things that are actually going to get you killed.
Yeah.
This is why, like when the seminar is saying, if the guy's got a knife to your throat and says, give him the money, give me the money, give him the money.
Yeah.
You're in close quarter range.
Yeah,
yeah, man. If you're in this space and I got a knife, I'm telling you, give me your fucking shit now or else I'll kill you.
Yeah.
You give him whatever it takes. Because if I put you in a corner and I start going haywire on you, even if you're a great knife expert defense, you're going to get cut. You're going to get slashed.
Mm-hmm.
And if you try anything fancy, you're going to die.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like he's saying.
Put the ego aside.
Yeah. You got to put the ego aside.
Oh, I'm going to kick his ass.
Oh, man. You don't know who you're dealing with. You know what I mean? And size has very little to do with it. Look, it's a factor.
That was one of the biggest things that I saw yesterday.
Yeah, like size is a factor when you're, you know, it's not the biggest factor. It is one, but when, like, when you, you know, if you put a knife, if you give a 13-year-old a knife, he's no longer a 13-year-old. He's an attacker with a knife.
Yeah.
So you got to take it, you know, as serious as anybody else.
Yeah. Well, that and disciplines. You know, one of the biggest things was I came in today and I was telling people I went to the seminar, and I was telling Nick before, is that the two first questions that I got, the first person said, was it
Krav Maga?
Yeah, which I didn't know prior. And then the second one, the girl was, what discipline? And, you know, from yesterday, It doesn't matter.
Just, and you know,
it does not matter.
It's because here, well, this is, again, my truth, is that everybody needs to identify to something.
Yeah.
Everybody needs to say,
that's
my
good.
System is better than your system.
Yeah.
And I spent 15 years doing karate black belt, so like, you don't know. Everybody has that. So when people ask me, what is it? It's self-defense. But what kind? Self-defense, defending yourself. Yeah, but just, there's no specific. It evolves, it changes, it grows. It's what, you know, it's just as simple as self-defense.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, and I hate having to turn it into some kind of like structured box, and it should, no.
Because it's not.
It's not.
Yeah.
At the end, I'm giving you the tools.
Yeah.
At the end, you got to do whatever you got to do to protect yourself.
Yeah.
You know, and it's about, again, keeping it simple. It's concepts and strategies. You won't have time to memorize 15 blocks, 13 punches, 13 techniques.
And you're talking about if you punch me here, and then I punch you there, and then you have to punch me here, and then I'll punch you.
It doesn't work like that. Right?
We're not including weather or jackets or friends or a girlfriend or slipping on a crack in the sidewalk.
Yeah, even when I was doing the scenario, at one point, I slipped on the thing.
Yeah.
I was like, shit, this is real.
Yeah.
People
that could be asphalt in New York City. One step is bigger than the other.
That's it.
Or an umbrella or a trash.
You could get attacked in this room, in the elevator, in a staircase, in your car. It's going to change each and every single time.
Yeah. And also what I noticed too is that, and the reason why a discipline doesn't work is because in MMA, in boxing, in Muay Thai, there's rules, regulations. When a person goes down, it's done. Person goes down in the street,
you don't know.
You're fucked.
That's the scariest part.
Yeah, you don't know if you're getting kicked in the head, as you're mentioning. You really need it, as the company's called, Code Red. That's when you go Code Red.
Totally. Like, you know, like, I get in the ring with anybody.
Yeah.
Because I know,
you know
what's the worst that's going to happen.
Yeah.
I'm going to get knocked out, concussion, broken nose, worst. Am I afraid of him pulling out a knife and stabbing me after? No, the stretcher and the ambulance is right there.
Yeah.
In the street, you get knocked out.
Yeah.
They'll continue.
Yeah.
They'll pull out a knife and stab you. You don't know that.
Yeah.
You know, that's the danger and big difference between in and out of the ring. And that's why, like in the sound, I was telling you guys, it ain't a fair fight. Pick up fucking a chair, use an umbrella, hit him with anything you can, throw
shit. It's survival.
I'm holding a glass, snatch the glass over his head, do whatever it takes.
Yeah.
It's survival. It means you got to get out of this
office.
Wearing
a hat, take off the hat.
Yeah, take
doesn't
off
matter.
Your
belt, you had your belt out.
Yeah. You know, and the thing is, a lot of times that people will never think of that. But the fact that you've done this seminar, it's going to trigger next time. Say, oh yeah, I never thought I can use that chair. I can throw something. And even throwing something into space will buy you a few seconds to escape.
Yeah.
And that could save your life.
Yeah.
Versus you teaching you something fancy and saying, yeah, we'll trap the knife, grab him here, grab him there. That might get you killed.
Exactly.
Especially if you're learning something that's not realistic. And they do it because, hey, they want to make money.
Exactly.
Because it sells. Because it's easy. I'm going to watch it and learn it and I can do it. And then until it happens. And there's, you know, I take it so serious. What I do, I would never want anybody calling me saying, hey, I saw your video and I got killed because of it.
Mm-hmm.
That's
personal.
That's how serious I take what I do. I'm so passionate about it that I, like, to a certain extent, I feel responsible for people's lives and what I teach.
Yeah.
And it's YouTube, man. People teach all kinds of shit. You could do whatever you want. But for me, I take it so much at heart. Like when I teach, you see it, I teach it with passion. And I don't want to hear any of you guys come out and say, well, I tried that and got my ass kicked.
Yeah.
You know, so that's where it comes from.
Yeah. And with regards to the basics, I know, obviously, you have the biggest thing that you mentioned was awareness. So if you want to just elaborate on that, you know, and living in New York City, a little bit more challenging, but awareness is the biggest thing. And we did something that was amazing, which we turned down the lights and we had a knife. It was a fake knife, but we were all walking around. We had to discover who had the knife based on eye contact, who's nervous, who's clutching it, where were their hands, what were they doing. So I was aware in the subway, but I put it in quotes because I would have been knocked out. My hands were in my pockets.
And you know what? It's about making yourself a hard target. Now, I'll give you an example. We're walking in New York City right now. I'm in code yellow. What does that mean? There's a lot of people. It's impossible for me to pinpoint anything. But I remember one point I was walking here, hey, that hey, I'm going to turn around and see who is he saying hey, is something happening, something going. I'm going to turn around and see them. That, you know, you can't scan everybody. Now, when we were walking last night, you know, 1:30 in the morning, you walk by me, everybody, I would take a picture of him. Boom, where's his hands? You know, is there anything out of the ordinary? How did he look at me? His body language? How is he walking? How is he coming close to me? it's instinctive for me, and that's enough to tell an attacker, well, you know, he might not attack me, but he's going to attack you because you have got your earphones on, texting, and you're not even, you have no clue he's even behind you. Next thing you know, boom, he's not going to knock you out from behind us that quick. Like the knockout game, people were knocking people in New York out.
Yeah.
People are slashing people in the face.
Yeah.
How did he get that close? How didn't you not see him or hear him?
Yeah.
Were you reading your book?
Everyone's got their headphones in.
I can't even see.
Like, everyone has their headphones.
Like, I'm guilty.
Completely unaware.
I tried it once in a drill that we did, and I got nervous just because I couldn't hear
anything.
You can't hear a car.
Yeah.
You can't hear,
a door slam.
A door slam.
Yeah.
Or, let's see, there's a shooter. You'll be like, what the fuck? Bam, bam, bam. Like, you know what I mean? It's that quick. And those are the little things that are going to make all the difference. And I like to emphasize that so much that people just, so I can trigger in their brains, make yourself a hard target.
What do you mean by that?
Like, just by being aware, being in the present moment, walking a certain way, your shoulders up, your head up high, moving around.
With purpose.
With purpose, you know, is enough to send the message that I know you're there, I'm not a victim.
Yeah.
It's so much of that is that. And the difference between him attacking you or the next guy will come down to that.
Yep.
Having your hands in your pocket like you did, the guy walking up to you, if he decided to punch you, you are out.
Done.
Even if he faced you, you'd
hit
never
me,
have enough
my
time.
My head against the door, the subway car back, boom, again, out.
No,
it's
just
not
by
the
keeping
first
your
one.
Hands up like I showed you
yeah,
here.
So, yeah,
here,
so the first thing is awareness. Say someone does circle around you at a club, a bar, outside, wherever.
Yeah, the first thing is you want to face them. You always want to be, facing them, that you're not just, you see him and the guy's kind of mouthing off and you just kind of ignore it and he comes off to the side and he sucker punches you. The difference between me moving around them, talking to him, bringing up my hands, start talking to the person, engage.
Never turn your back.
Never turn your back.
Yeah, you always
or your side,
center,
right? Because if I come to the side, I'll knock you out there.
Yeah.
So just that already, you're eliminating.
Literally, this is.
Just this.
Yeah.
Or
this
here,
is all.
Here, I'm talking to the person. My hands are up. What's up, buddy? What do you need? What do you want? Like, and then he pushes and grabs you. Then I'll go into a passive stance.
Yeah.
Cover my angles. And then if I need, I'll go preemptive.
Yeah.
And like I said, you either defuse a situation or you hit him first.
Yeah.
Hit him when he's talking. Ask him a question, man.
So from that stance, if he comes in aggressively,
boom.
You
can elbow, I can hammer fist, I can palm strike, I can block, but my hands are up, his hands are down.
Yeah.
It's not about how...
And what you said yesterday is that you, by the time your eye sees, then registers, and you put your hands up...
I've hit my target.
Yeah.
He won't even see it, especially if I use verbal, if I lower his guard, if I'm not challenging...
Which is huge, talk about that.
Well, look...
Boosting his ego.
Yeah, it's psychology. I don't, if the guy's mouthing off and I mouth back, well, you're going to escalate it. There's no point.
Yeah.
So my objective is to defuse and de-escalate or go preemptive and hit the person first.
Yeah.
When he's talking as fast and as hard, I want to lower his guard and raise his ego. Look, man, what do you want? I don't want to have any trouble. Let's talk about it. We are, but just me saying let's talk about it, I'm going to get engaged and find, well, what does he want from me? Why is he coming up? Does he think I'm somebody else?
Yeah.
Does he want my money? Doesn't like my face? Does he think I was hitting on his girlfriend? You might be like, oh, shit, sorry, man. I was looking, I was just looking that direction, but I really wasn't looking at her. You know, you're a lucky guy. She's a beautiful girl, but, I'm married,
Yeah,
fuck you. Get out of here. All right, man. Cool. I'll just walk away. Boom. You just defused it.
Yeah.
Now he grabs you. He's like, fuck you. I don't give a shit. I'm going to fucking. Then you have to make the decision whether you go preemptive or not.
Yeah.
If you don't see his hands and you think he's got a weapon, I'm going to strike him. I'm not going to take the chance for him to pull out a weapon or wait for his friends to come out and then circle me. And then you're put in a, turn into a 1-on-1 and a 2-on-1 and a 3-on-1 with a weapon. That's
When he goes, hey, we got something over here. And he calls over his friends.
Yeah.
And
then it's
like,
shit.
Like, here we go.
At that point, you fucking run.
Yeah.
Let them run after you. Because I'm not going to sit there and be like, hey, buddy, what's up, man?
Yeah.
You're setting yourself up. You're allowing him to set up that strike and that, so the fight starts. Like I tell you, the fight starts the instant you make visual or intuitive contact. Feel something,
Something's a little bit off.
I saw something.
Yeah.
The instant you feel that the fight starts dead, what do I do from now? Do I continue walking or do I turn around and find a way to go around them?
Yeah.
Do I turn around and face them? What do I do from that moment? That's when the fight starts. That will make all the difference on whether I'm going to get in close and stab you or make it hard just by through awareness and positioning myself in certain places or being able to turn around or using something as an obstacle to create some distance between him picking on somebody else.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Just that.
And then from there, the preemptive, where would you say, how close or what would they need to do for you to go to preemptive?
Well, look, if the person...
Preemptive is obviously initiating before...
Yeah. And I'm
they
like,
do anything.
I'm like a huge fan of that, right? I always tell people, especially these guys, like, you know,
someone might go to the hospital and sure as hell is not going to be met.
That, you know, and
yeah.
you're not a fighter, right? You don't do this
yeah.
for a living.
This is my full-time job. I'm
not
going to paid for this.
You know, you're not going to go and fight MMA 3 times a week and
yeah.
get somebody attacks you. Look, you have a business, you work, and we have to be realistic. You took a seminar. You might take some classes once a week. So I got to teach you how to fight as simple as possible with your natural instincts and your reflexive response versus timing and speed.
Yeah.
At one point, if the guy's going to attack you, he's going to come into your face, unless he's ambushing you, but the defense is awareness.
Exactly.
At one point, he's going to come, he's going to push, he's going to shove, he's going to grab you, he might sucker punch you.
Yep.
Your hands are going to come up. And here's the trick I tell people. When do I go preemptive?
Yep.
The instant the person is no longer communicating.
Yeah.
If I'm talking to you and you're not responding to my question, you're just, fuck you, shut up. And that means he's boiling it up.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't really give a shit right now. I'm just going to kick the fuck out of you.
Yeah, yeah.
That's when you got to make the decision. All right, I'm striking this guy.
Because he made the decision. He doesn't care what you said.
He doesn't give a shit at that.
Yeah.
You know
he wanted
I mean?
He wanted something.
He wants it.
And you are it.
Example,
yeah.
like, you know, over a parking spot.
Yeah.
You know, you get out. Man, it's my fucking... Oh, man, I'm really sorry, man. You get the fuck out now. Shit, man, look, I was here and, you know, like, I'm going to fucking kick your ass. Move your car. All right, buddy, you know what? Fuck it. Just take it. I'm not going to fight over a spot.
Yeah.
That's scenario one.
Yeah.
Scenario two, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to kick your ass. Look, man, I don't give a fuck. And he's no longer talking to me. He doesn't
yeah.
give a shit anymore. I just want to beat your face because I don't like it.
Yeah.
Because I feel insecure because you fucking look good. You're dressed nice. You're driving a fancy car.
Yeah.
And I'm pissed and I want to beat the shit out of you because
yeah.
that's what's going to give me some kind of... It's going to feed my ego or purpose.
Exactly.
Or
approval.
Approval or whatever
yeah.
it is.
Yeah.
So at that point, you got to make the decision. Fuck it. This guy's no longer... He's not looking to talk or negotiate or find some middle
ground.
I got to
put him down.
I
got to
put
yeah.
him down.
Yeah.
I got to knock him out.
Yeah. And the initial, like you said yesterday, is everything.
It's the first
strike. Initial contact needs to be you if it's...
Yes. That first strike is the most important one. Like in my
yeah.
videos, I got moved 6'6", 350 pounds, 6'6".
Yeah.
He decides to throw first... And he knocks you out, man, you're going to sleep for a week.
Yeah.
Even if I block it, if I don't block it
yeah.
super fast.
Now you're in defensive mode.
It's just so bad, yeah.
Pure defensive mode. Yeah,
like
yeah.
moves,
and he starts charging, yeah.
You got to headbutt him, you got to elbow him, you got to eye gouge him, smash
yeah.
his head on the floor.
Yeah.
Because it's like a big bear that just keeps coming. So
yeah.
if you don't get that first strike, every second that you take is less to your advantage.
Yep.
Every second that I'm waiting, he's going to build up more. So once you... Strike him first with
you
a
got
palm
hit
strike.
Hard.
Hit him in the throat.
Yeah.
Palm strike or headbutt. You
and then
do
the biggest
not
thing,
stop.
Yeah, you said keep on going.
Keep on. Like
it's
like,
not just one.
No, it's palm
it's
and elbow and hammer fist.
Yeah.
And you got to go
you
in like a
down.
Machine gun.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I don't want to bank on me hitting him
and he's
him
still
getting
there.
Up. Oh, fuck that.
Yeah.
Run.
Yeah.
Run. So that first strike has got to be followed with big blows as fast and as hard as possible.
Yeah. Which is totally different than MMA. You know, one of the biggest things of being on the floor. You know, they're really good at
oh.
grappling.
Yeah,
you're not even gonna get there.
No, you do. Let's say you do.
If you do, you got a broken nose already. Or
you get a guy like Moose on the floor.
Yeah, get him off of you.
Get
yeah.
him off of you, right?
Yeah.
And the energy it's gonna take for you to put an armbar or leg lock.
While he's fighting street.
Was he? Yeah, you're going for.
he's got your hair
smashing
to
on
the
floor.
Concrete.
He's gonna
yeah.
bite you. He's gonna
yeah.
eye gouge you. He's gonna fish hook you if he has
yeah.
to. He's gonna rip your nose.
Yeah,
you know.
There's
I mean?
No
so,
rules.
There's no
that's
rules.
The biggest thing people think. Yeah.
That's why, like MMA fighters, and they're great fighters. You get a really good skills, but you know that they're gonna fight a certain way.
Yeah.
They don't scare me as much as the street guy, because the street guy doesn't give a fuck. The guy's been in prison. He'll fucking eye gouge you. He'll be
yeah.
like, yeah, man, it's cool, all right, man. As you turn around, boom, sucker punch you.
Exactly.
That's how they're gonna fight.
Yeah.
He doesn't give two shits what he's gonna use.
Yeah.
Whereas the MMA guy or the karate guy has been taught discipline and to fight with honor.
Exactly.
It's not about honor. You want honor?
Matter.
Go fight like that. In the street,
exactly.
Do what you gotta do.
Yeah. Yeah, and one thing that was never taught to any guy ever at any time was with a girlfriend. You know, it's like, I actually have a cousin that was leaving a bar. He's FDNY, he's a big guy, he's 6'4", 6'5", definitely worth his weight in gold. But his girlfriend was just chirping to the bouncer. Then their friend was there, and my cousin was like, Marissa, shut up.
Yeah.
He's like, why are you talking right
yeah.
now?
Are
I'm
you,
the, and she's 5'2".
Are you going to fight?
Yeah.
Or is it me
not
who's
like
gonna
she's
fight?
Going to get involved anyway. Even if she was 6 foot, she's not getting involved. And she's 5'2". And he's like, Marissa, shut up. And that's the biggest thing is that, you know, what you said was don't have her antagonize. Don't have her right behind with you right on the back. And always have the center of line, her to the attacker. And then once a hit happens and she can run, go
get
and
out.
Call.
That's it.
Yeah.
It's a simple.
And no guy, I guarantee it's always the guy and the girl right next to
right.
each other.
And that's That's not taught. I haven't seen it in self-defense. I'm not just saying because I teach it. I've never seen it.
Yeah.
And it's only because through experience that happened once that I realized, okay, I need to create something. And before it was basically you're in front of the other person, but then you don't know where they are.
Yeah.
So the guy's moving here, the other one's moving there. I'm like, where is she?
Yeah.
So just by placing your hand, and it could be your girlfriend, your wife, but it could also be a friend who doesn't know how to fight.
Exactly.
You know, where you say, look, just like, let me just stay behind, let me handle this.
Yeah. And I think psychologically for the male, he wants to know where she is. So he always would place her within, you know, this area, but you don't know if that friend has someone else. And like you said, is if I'm fighting him, I'm also looking out for her.
I'd rather she run
and
get
away.
Out and let me handle it versus me having to fight protecting her at the same time.
Exactly.
And not knowing that even if I go down, well, she's going to go, they're going to come after her too. So that's just my approach and strategy to that.
Yeah. Yeah. And you know, I'll just end it on the fact of coming as a civilian, coming as a guy that, you know, I've played rugby, I still play hockey, and it's, you know, aggressive sports. I've got scars all over my body. I've been in fights and everything else. When it comes to the street, it's totally different. And the biggest thing is no judgment.
Yeah.
Because when I showed up yesterday, I was like, and you know, I've seen your clips and everything else, and when you see it online, you don't know how hard you're striking. You don't feel the impact. But once you start blocking, once you start grappling, then you feel it. And the biggest thing is, you know, you may look at Nick and judge Nick because he's not the prototypical bouncer that you see, which is 6'6", you know, like Moose.
Yeah.
You know, but when you're grappling, you know, and you had my hand, it was only one, and it one hand, and I couldn't, and it was simulating a knife, I couldn't move my hand. So do not judge. You know, you probably have some stories on that of seeing either a short guy or a little guy, and or even a girl that...
First, you got the adrenaline factor. People fucking could do so much shit under adrenaline.
Yeah.
Right?
Or drugs. Like
drugs,
you're saying.
Too.
Yeah.
Guys on blow or fucking. There's superhuman strength there, too. There's no doubt in terms of, like, I've seen little guys take on big guys. But a lot of the times, it's not because of strength, because they're fucking crazy. One's crazier than the other sometimes.
Yeah.
Right? Now, don't get me wrong in terms of, like, when you know, this is what I do for a living. So, yeah, I work my grip strength like crazy, man. I put towels and I do chin-ups because I understand the importance of grip when I'm trapping or when I'm striking.
Yeah.
So, you know, I also train for that. You know what I mean? I know that you might be big, but are you fast?
Yeah.
Do you have time?
Speed.
Do you have speed?
What was the McGregor quote?
Precision beats power and timing beats speed.
Yeah.
And that's when I heard that, I was
brilliant.
Like, wow, you might have the best punch, but if you can't hit a target, it's useless.
Exactly.
And the greatest example I can give you is that, you know, this was years back, a guy that trained at my gym for almost like 6-7 years, he could hit a bag better than anybody. Like, I mean, it was like, bah, bah. He looked like amazing. Like, when he hit the bag, you think, wow. And then I was training a beginner for about 3 months in the ring. So I took him in the ring, and I trained him straight in the ring. I put them both in the ring.
Yeah.
When he was ready. The guy after like 70 years ago, I'm going to get in the ring. The guy in 3 months destroyed him.
Yeah.
Destroyed him because he had no concept of, oh, I'm going to get hit now. No concept of the timing and the speed and the movement and the slipping. And now you're not just hitting a bag. You're hitting something that's moving, hitting back.
Exactly.
And the fact that he'd never been hit in the face, he was like, what the fuck?
That's it. Who is it? Mike Tyson said, everything changes when you get punched in the face.
Everybody has a plan until they get punched in the face.
It's
one of
so
the
true.
Best quotes, man.
Yeah.
And that goes for anything in life, right?
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
In business or whatever, you have a plan. Suddenly, boom, it's like, okay.
Bankruptcy.
Time to
divorce.
Redirect a whole fucking plan.
Yeah.
What am I doing?
Yeah.
You know?
So children, something.
It's the same, and a lot of times in my self-defense, what am I trying to develop people is their awareness, but also their mindset.
Yeah.
What is your mindset?
Yeah.
What do you think of yourself? I could tell just your mindset, you don't have a victim mindset, that's for sure. Even if you did.
Anti-victim.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Even if you
would have. Pro-responsibility.
Even if you would have got knocked out. Listen, that guy would have knocked you out.
Yeah.
He would have not knocked you out because you're a victim. He would have knocked you out because you didn't know what to do.
Exactly.
There's a very big difference.
What is the difference?
Victim is a story that I always share. When I was working in one of the clubs, I was finishing the nightclub. I was finishing the club. It was maybe 4 a.m. And I'm walking down the street. It's completely dark. It's a quiet night. And I see this woman walking towards me. And I look at her, and she sees me. She gets scared, and she's crouched over.
Oh,
and she's walking to the side. And I look at her, I'm thinking, fuck. If I'm an attacker,
you're done.
I already know you're scared. You've told yourself, holy shit, I can't do anything. You're walking under your body language. Everything says you are ready to be, like, if I
whatever
grab
you
and be
want.
Like, oh my God, please don't hurt me. Boom, I have full control.
Yeah.
And I remember walking that across the street. I went around the cars to let her pass. I didn't want to scare her.
Yeah.
I was so scared I mean, I my instinct was to say, excuse me, like, just, I don't want to scare you. But I was so scared to even do that because I think she would run or yell and freeze
yeah.
to the point that I didn't even want to stop her to tell, look, I'm a self-defense instructor. Look, this is what I do.
Yeah.
I just want to tell you the way you're walking and what you do
is
that bad.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the difference.
You should have a card and just say, you need to come to my
and
head.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
But you know what? The victim mindset is, to me, and I didn't know you coming in. I know you now, successful real estate, everything that you've done. You don't get there through being a victim.
Yeah.
It's the same mindset.
Yeah.
You don't.
It is literally impossible.
Yes, no.
Because you have no abundance.
I don't know Tony Robbins, but I doubt Tony Robbins walks down the street and someone's going to say, let me go pick on that guy.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Because his energy and his strength and his.
Yeah. He walks, his arms are out here. He's literally knuckle dragging.
Yeah. You know, and it's not only because of his size, but his energy.
Yeah. Yeah, you feel it. Yeah.
You know, so it's the same mindset. You can't be a victim in the street and be afraid, and be a victim in your business and whatever it is.
Relationships, anything.
Give you a great example. I was training a guy one time. The guy was loaded, Ferrari, the whole shebang. And I was telling him, well, if somebody says, give me your money, you should, give him the money. He's like, I'm not giving him my money.
Yeah.
Because you know how hard I've worked for that money? I don't want it. I said, I want you to teach me how to fight not to give him my money. And I looked at him and I said, okay, that's what you want? I can't tell you you should value your life more than your money. I believe that, but at the end, it's your thing. At the end, it's your thing. So what did I do? I taught him, well, this is what you should do. At the end, it's your life.
Yeah.
But that's his mindset.
Yeah, unfortunately.
Unfortunately.
You don't know the situation.
You don't know, but again, I wouldn't go that way, but hey, that's what I trained them to do.
Exactly. Yeah, well, listen, you got to check him out. Where can people find you?
NickDrossos.com on YouTube or Code Red Defense.
Yeah, that's it?
That's it.
Follow him on Instagram as well.
Instagram, favorite.
The favorite social media network.